Okay. Good afternoon, my students. Yeah, welcome again. So this is Teacher Tajudeen. We have to continue the mathematics again. We stopped last time. We talked about equation with variable on both sides. So now today also we continue, and we have to end this topic today. Today is going to be the last day of this topic. Then the next lesson will be another topic. Okay. So now let's continue from here. Can you hear me now? Okay, never mind to say anything yet. If you have questions, we want to start the lesson now. If you have any question, just put up your hand after the class. Now, or during the as the class is going, when it's time for you to ask any question, I'll let you know. If you know how to raise up hand from the Zoom, you can easily click on it, or you raise up your finger like this, then I'll see you. Okay, so now from here, find the solution set of the following numbers. Okay, the first question here, you have x over 2 equals open bracket x minus 5 over 3. So to solve this one, we say solution. It's okay like this. Solution. Okay. Now you repeat the question by saying number one, we have x over 2 equals open bracket x minus 5 close bracket over 3. So here we need to turn this, we need to solve this side first. We find the LSM of both sides, okay? We find the LSM of this one and this, which is 2 and 3. We find the LSM of 2 and 3. Okay, now here, what could be the LSM? We multiply this number by this number to make the LSM of it. So, now if you multiply 2 by 3, that is 6. So, which means 3, you cannot hear me? Okay, which means 6 is the LSM of both sides. Now here, we say multiply both sides. Multiply both sides by 6. So since 6 is the LSM, so we say multiply both sides by 6. Now from here you repeat the question by saying x over 2 multiplied by 6 equals open bracket x minus 5 close bracket over 3 multiplied by 6. This is what we just say now. Here we say multiply both sides by 6. So here the multiplication here, this 6 standing alone, so that you will not be confused. The 6 standing alone can be over 1. It's still the same thing, okay? And also here can be over 1. Okay? So now, from here, you have x over 2 multiplied by 6 over 1. We can cut from here easily. This is 6, this is 2. They can cut each other from here, okay? So how many 2 can you get from 2? That is 1, right? So we have turned this to 1. Then how many 2 can we get from 6? That is 3, okay? So now here we have x, we have 3. When you come to this side, let's write what we have here. 3 times x, you multiply this side by itself, 3 multiplied by x, we have 3x. Okay, now we divide, the same thing we did here is what we are going to do this side also. So how many 3 can we get from 3? That is 1. Okay, so let me check my students. Okay, are you on? Okay, Mwafi, you're online. Mwafi, your speaker is off, so you will not be able to hear me. Yes, Nyande, your speaker is set now. I am sure you can hear me now. Okay, so let's continue. From here, you have how many 3 can we get from 3 is 1. Okay, how many 3 can you get from 6 here, which is 2. Understood? So here now we have x inside the bracket and the minus 5, then you have 2 outside the bracket. What does it mean?
you are going to multiply these two by all the numbers
inside the brackets. Okay?
You will multiply these two here by all the numbers
inside the brackets.
So let's do that.
2 multiplied by x, we have 2x. Okay? So now your minus, you put it here. Okay? 2 multiplied by 5, that is 10. Okay? We have 10. Now look at it. From here, you have 3x equals 2x minus 10. Okay?
So here we have to think of a number to cancel this, to eliminate the second variation, which is this 2x. So we use 2x, we can say, since the 2 is positive, because I said it last time, any number standing alone without a negative sign before it is a positive number. So from here you will just say, subtract. Subtract, this is 2, right? Minus 2 from both sides. Okay, here we say subtract minus 2 from both sides. If you remember, because of this, the number here is 2, so we say subtract minus 2 from both sides. So if you want to subtract, you say 3x minus this minus 2, okay, minus 2. Now equals this side. Now we have 2x, this is 2x, then we say minus 2 again, so minus 2. Now here we have minus 10, repeat the number again. Sorry, 2x, sorry, here we have x, okay. Okay, so we subtract minus 2x from both sides, okay? So that 3x minus 2x, you have x. Understood? Your 3x minus 2x, you have x. Now, equal sign, you introduce your equal sign. Then, this is 2x, this is plus 2x minus 2x. Plus and minus cancel each other, okay? It cancels. Now, what you have left here is minus 10. Here you have minus 10 at the end. So, that minus 10, there's nothing to divide or minus or subtract from it. So, you repeat the number here again. So, you have your x equals minus 10. Now, since the question says find the solution set of each of the following. Now, the solution set, after you finish, you say the solution set equals inside the bracket minus 10. So now the solution set, the solution set equals minus 10. Maybe a speaker. Use another phone. Okay? So, now, this is the first question. We have solved it. And then we take the next question now. Where is it? So here we have number 2. Okay? We have 3 open brackets. Z. This my Z look like 2. Let me set it. Okay? Minus 1, then close the bracket, equals 2, open bracket, z plus 1, then close the bracket. Now, so this is the second question. So before I solve this, let me check my student and see if you all get the speaker right. She can't hear me, right, Hadut? Okay. I will open your speaker now so that you talk, if you can hear me right from home. Okay. Yes, Adut, you can talk now. Can you hear me? Hello, Adut. Can you hear me? Now, what is the problem with the speaker here? It seems you can't hear me, but I'm hearing you from your side. Let me help you. Okay, Moafi, I'll on your speaker. Please let me know if you are hearing me, if you can hear me, okay? Moafi, talk. Can you hear me now? Hello, Moafi. Can you hear me? Don't off your speaker, leave it on. I want you to talk, okay? I on your speaker, okay? Don't off it again, Moafi. I want you to talk. I want to know if you can hear me. Hello? Can you hear me, Moafi?
Sir?
Okay. I will on all your speakers. Okay, maybe I use headset.
Yes.
Maybe I use headset if you can, so that you can hear me. Okay, let me check now. Okay. Now I want to unmute all of you so that any of you can talk if you can hear me. Hello? Okay, Lino, can you hear me now? Okay, that's good. Okay, we can start. I'll unmute all of you.
Our dude is yet to...
Okay, sorry, I have stopped all your speakers now. Since you can hear me now, we can continue the lesson now from here. Okay, so the second question is this. Okay, the second question, you have 3 open bracket z minus 1 close bracket equals 2 open bracket z plus 1 and close bracket. So we solve this by multiplying straight away this number outside the bracket by all the numbers inside the bracket. Okay, you multiply straight away, which means 3 multiplied by z, you have 3z. Okay, now 3, this is your minus, bring it out, then 3 multiplied by 1, that is 3. You get it how we open the bracket now? Okay, so we multiply this 3 by all the numbers inside the bracket in order to open the bracket. Now from here again, we have the equal sign introduced, then 2 multiplied by z in order to open the second bracket equals 2z. Okay, now introduce your plus sign, addition sign, then 2 multiplied by 1 equals 2. You see how we open the two brackets now? Now, here we multiply this one, the 3, by z, we have 3z, then the subtraction sign, we bring it out, then 3 multiplied by 1, we have 3. Okay? So now from here also, we multiply 2 multiplied by z, we have 2z, then addition sign, we bring it out, then 2 multiplied by 1, we have 2. Okay? So now from this side we have 2 variables now, which is 3z and 2z. So the first thing to do is to cancel this, find a number to eliminate the second variable, which is, this is positive, as you can see there's no any negative sign before you, so it is positive. So in that case we just say subtract minus 2z from both sides. Okay, so subtract minus 2z, put it in a bracket, from both sides, which means we are going to subtract minus 2z from this side, and then we subtract minus 2z from this side also. Now let's apply this. We have 3z, this is minus 2z, okay, minus 2z, okay, this is minus 3, so minus 3,
your equal sign. Now this side is filled up. If equal sign, you introduce it again. Okay, now this side we have 2z starting. So 2z. Now here we say minus 2z. So we have to put this one also minus 2z. Okay, this is plus 2. Okay, plus 2. So I think you can see now. We have set it. Now we have 3z minus 2z. That is 3 minus 2. 3 minus 2. So 3 you take away 2, you have z. Okay? It's supposed to be 1z. So 1z is the same thing as z. Okay? So you are not going to write that one. So you just write only z. Now, which means this side is solved. We have minus 3. So minus 3. Then equals. Here we have 2z, positive number, minus 2z. So positive and negative cancel each other with the same figure, okay? The positive and negative with the same figure cancel each other straight away. Okay, so now what we have left here is plus 2, okay? So since this one has canceled this, you have plus 2. So you just write 2. You don't need to put plus, since the number is starting alone, so you don't need to put the plus, okay? So now here we have z minus 3 equals 2. Now, we want to know what exactly what is our z. So we see minus 3 here. Now, here we need to apply the additive inverse of minus 3. The additive inverse of minus 3 is plus 3. So from here we say add plus 3 to both sides. Okay? So here we say add plus 3 to both sides because the additive inverse of minus 3 is plus 3. So I'll clean this side, the beginning here. So never mind, I'll clean the board now from this side. The video, you will get it back on YouTube, okay? We share the YouTube link. We share our YouTube link into the group, into our WhatsApp group, so that you can copy the question from there, okay? So I'll clean the beginning here. I'll clean this side. So that we can complete the question. We have solved number one. I can clean it now. So we are solving number two now, okay? So here we say, let me repeat the question again. Since we say add plus 3 to both sides, we have to repeat the question here. Z minus 3 equals 2. Then, but here we say add plus 3 to both sides. Let's apply it now. Which means we have Z minus 3 plus 3 equals 2 plus 3. Because here says add plus 3. Add plus 3 to both sides. So we add this plus 3 here. We add this plus 3 here also. Okay? So that this is negative 3 plus 3 will cancel each other. Just like I have said, any negative and positive number with starting with each other with the same figure will cancel each other automatically, okay? Now, what you have left this side now is z equals, now, 2 plus 5, 2 plus 3. The answer is 5, okay? You see it now? The answer is 5. Now, since the question say find the solution set, here you now say the solution set equals 5. Okay, so this is the final answer for the second question. This is the final answer. Let me check on you, my student, again and see if you all get the speaker right. Okay, Alec, you will not be able to hear me because your speaker is off. You did not on your speaker, so you won't be able to hear me. Okay. So now let's take the last question, which is this one. Let me clean the board again. Where's my? Okay.
Now I can claim this side, which is number 2, is solved. Okay. Number 2 is solved. Now we have to, let me write number 3 here, question 3. We have 3 open bracket, x minus 3, close bracket, equals open bracket, x minus 14, and then close bracket.
I don't know if you can, because now
the
parents are coming, we don't know who's you.
Yeah.
Let us pray,
we will please. Okay. This is the last question I will solve with you now. Before I ask if any of you have questions, then I'll open your speaker for you to ask your question. Okay. So now, to solve this side, we want to solve the last question here now. We have 3 outside the bracket, then inside the bracket you have x minus 3. So, and I said you need to multiply.
It seems that no bracket is chosen from this. This one.
Okay, over 4, yeah. Divided by 4, sorry. Okay. So, we need to multiply the number outside the bracket now by all the numbers inside the bracket straight away to open this bracket. So what to do? 3 multiplied by x, that is 3x. Okay? So now this minus, bring it out, then 3 times 3 we have 9. Okay. Now the bracket is open. Okay, we come to this side. We have x minus 14 and then 1. Let me repeat the question here. 3x minus 9, let me write it down. 3x minus 9. Okay, now I want to repeat this question here. X minus 14 all over 4. Now, this 3x minus 1 is the same thing as over 1. You make it over 1. Why? So that you can find the LCM of 4 and 1. Okay? Since the number is standing alone, you make it over 1 so that you can find the LCM of 4 and 1. And LCM of 4 and 1 is what? That is 4. The LCM of 4 and 1 is 4. So, since the LCM is 4, you will now say multiply both sides by 4, okay, which is the LCM. Now, from here, we repeat the question by saying 3x minus 9 over 1 multiplied by 4. We say multiply both sides by 4. Okay? So we multiply over 1. Now, your equal sign, because this is what we have just done, 3x minus 9 over 1, we repeat the question here again, then say multiply by 4, because we say multiply both sides by 4 here. So now, the second question, we need to break this down also, which is x minus 14 over 4. Put this one inside the bracket. Okay, now multiply by 4. The same thing here. We have x minus 14 over 4 multiply by 4. Okay, so now what to do? This is 4. 1. How many 4 can we get from 4? That is 1, okay? And then here, 1. The 4 cancel each other here, okay? Running time out. We didn't set time. I never spend 30 minutes?
Yes.
Okay, no problem. I have 10 minutes to conclude the class. Okay. So, now here we have 4 has cancelled this 4, which means what we have left now is x minus 14. Let's clean this side and start from here. Now, in case the time finish, the class end before, if the meeting end before I finish the class, I will schedule again and give it another 10 minutes or 20 minutes so that we can conclude the class. So if you want to join, you will join with the same link, okay? You will join back with the same link in case this stops, okay? So now, here we have 3x, okay? This one now, you are going to multiply it by this 4, okay? You multiply all this number now by this 4. Which means we have 4 multiplied by 3x, that is 12x, okay? 12x. Now, this is your minus, minus. Now, 4 multiplied by 9, 4 multiplied by 9, that is 18, 36, right? Okay. Let's answer that. Okay. So, from here we have 12x minus 36, okay? Which is the multiplication of 4 multiplied by the numbers inside this bracket. So the equal sign, you introduce your equal sign, then you come back here again, you have x minus 14, x minus 14, that's what you have left here. So x minus 14. So that is it now. We have x minus 14 as the last number here. So now we have 12x. And then here we have x standing alone, okay? X standing alone. So what to do, we just subtract x from both sides, okay? In order to cancel this one, we say subtract x. Subtract x from. Okay. Subtract x from both sides. Why do we say so? We want to cancel this x. Okay? We want to cancel this x. Now we say 12x minus x minus 36. Okay? Equals x minus x minus 14. Understood now? Since we say subtract x from both sides, this is our 12x, 12x, we repeat it here again. This is minus, minus. Now, the x we say we subtract from both sides, this is it, okay? So, now, and then the 36, here is it. Now, the equal sign, we repeat it. Then the x here, here is it. Then the minus x here, here is it. Now, minus 14, bring it down, okay? So now from here, this x will cancel this, and then this side, 12x minus x, you have 11x. Now, minus 36 equals minus 14. Okay, so now here we have minus 14. We want to cancel this 36, and this 36 is minus 36. So here we think of the additive inverse of minus 36 is plus 36. The additive inverse of minus 36 is plus 36. So here we say add plus 36 to both sides. Okay, we say add plus 36 to both sides. Why do we say so? We want to cancel this 36. Okay, so we repeat the question here by saying 11x minus 36. Now this plus 36 equals minus 14. Minus 14 plus 36. Okay? So, minus 14 plus 36. Now, this is minus 36 and this is plus 36. They cancel each other. Okay? Minus and then the plus cancel each other. So what we have left this side is 11x. Okay? 11x. Now, yeah, input sign. Okay. Minus 14 plus 36. Okay? Minus 14 plus 36. Yeah. The time will soon end now. Let's add to the time because I will see my student may have questions. Okay, I have just 7 participants. I will add to the time soon. Okay, can you turn the speaker and answer it now? So that before we finish, I'll give them the classwork also. It's only 2 minutes now. It will end in 2 minutes. Okay. Okay, please, students, I want to end this class. I'll add to the time. Then you join again with the same link, okay? You will join back with the same link. You end this one first. End it, and then add
the classmates are all I'm doing it for me.
Okay. End it. What is time now?
It's 2:53.
Akwata.
I hope they will get the list in the material because that's what you came.
You pause it. Okay. So my students, we have to continue the class from where we stopped here. We said 11x minus, so we have done this side. Remaining this, which is minus 14 plus 36. Please cancel your speaker there. Okay, so minus 11x equals minus 14 plus 36. So, 36, sorry. Okay, so minus 14 plus 36, it means you are going to minus this 14 from this 36, okay? You minus this 14 from this 36. By doing that, we said 11x equals 4, 6 minus 4 is 2, okay? 3 minus 1, that is 2. So which means you have 22. 11x equals 22, okay? So from here, we want to know exactly what is our x without this 11. So since 11 is starting behind the x, we say divide. Both sides by 11. Okay, so since this is 11 with the x, so here we take the question by saying 11x all over 11 equals 22 over 11. Okay, so that this 11 cancels this. Understood? So now what we have left here is x. Now, this equal sign introduced. Now, how many 11 can we get from 11? That is 1. Okay? So, how many 11 can we get from 22? That is 2. Okay? So, the answer now is 2. Here you will now say the solution set equals 2 inside the bracket, okay? Okay, so this is the final answer. The solution set equals 2. Now, from here, I can see one of my students put up hand. I want to know who is this person. Though you did not write your name, okay? You let me off everybody's speaker. Okay, so this person, you can talk now, please. Ask a question now. You did not write your name. I don't know who the person is. Your speaker is on already. You can talk. Who is that? No name. It just shows. Okay. So it seems you cannot. No response from you. So I'll have to continue my class from this side. So we have solved the last question here. Now, I will give you
homework to solve, okay? You have homework to solve. Just make sure after watching this video, you click from the YouTube, go back to YouTube after this class again, so that you can take the lesson back again. Then make sure you click on subscribe button, okay? Subscribe, so that you can have all the lessons every day. You can have all the lessons, notifications every day. So now try to solve this. I think this is simple now. So we call this homework. So number one, we have open bracket x plus 1 and then close bracket equals 4. So try to solve this. And then we have number 2. This one is a little bit long. I want to try your understanding now. Minus 3, close bracket, minus 2, open bracket, y plus 4, close bracket, equals 6, y minus 24. Okay, so this is the two questions I will give you. The first question is 2 open bracket x plus 1 equals 4. Now the second question, 3 open bracket y minus 3, then minus 2 open bracket y plus 4, close bracket, equals 6 y minus 24. Okay, so now you try to solve this question at home, and then the next lesson I will, anybody who got it right, you show me the question, show me the answers. Then anybody who got it wrong will be able to solve it from here, and as a revision also, so that others will know it. Now this person is still putting up hand. I don't know the person because he did not write your name.
I got him answer now.
He did not write your name, so I don't know who the person is. So I can, let me unmute all of you now, so that if anybody have question, you're free to answer, okay? You're free to ask your questions. Sorry. Okay, so everybody now, your speaker is on. Your speaker is on. If anybody have question, you are free. Free to ask a question now. If no question, take home the homework I have given you, then try to solve it at home. Yes, I see another hand
okay,
again.
His name is Mudu Deng.
Let me see.
Adult Deng.
No.
That's yes, Adult Deng.
That is Adult? No, yes. It's not Adult.
Okay,
it's him. Who is using? Okay, please, off this camera. The class has finished already. So, thank you, my students. We meet next lesson, which is the next lesson now is English. So, then after the English, later we have math. Then we continue to play this question. Thank you.